Premier Chris Minns and his South Australian counterpart joined forces today, chatting with school children about curbing social media. Both leaders telling the Sydney summit restricting the age limit to 16 years and over would help prevent depression among teens.
Tech billionaire Mark Zuckerberg showing off the supersized Porsche that social media built. A Facebook brag from the Facebook creator. An alternate reality that experts say is harming Australian kids. Today in Darling Harbour, some old-fashioned FaceTime.
Yeah, I'm Chris.
Premier Chris Minns and South Australia's Peter Malinauskas showing young people how to network offline. A first of its kind, two-leader, two-state social media summit declaring war on the global giants.
People that have got billions to make and have made over the past decade.
We cannot allow social media companies to industrialise addiction of young people for their financial benefit.
Tonight, renewed calls for regulation with psychological evidence from around the world.
The links between social media use and depression are stronger among those ages 15 and younger.
Peter Malinauskas hitting the like button on a New South Wales push for the social media age limit to be 16 and the need for a national approach.
I mean, what are we waiting for? The sooner we can get a piece of legislation passed by the federal parliament, whether it be at 16 or another age, that'll be a good day.
The federal government has already committed to an age ban, promising to pass legislation before the next election. Enforcing it, though, could depend entirely on the social media giants themselves.
People just put different ages. I've done it.
You can't stop kids doing what they're going to do.
Australia attempting what no country has managed before. So tonight, an interstate message for the titans of tech.
The richest, most powerful technology companies in the entire world that can guess what your favourite song and your favourite movie is without you even entering it are unable to tell what age you are. It's ridiculous.
Ruth Wynne-Williams, Nine News.